Today, we are going to do square root of 2 factorial. And of course, the usual definition, n times n minus 1 times dot 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 times 2 times 1, that's only good for positive whole number, so that's not going to work for us. In order to talk about this, we have to extend the concept of factorial by using a very nice integral. And let me write that down right here for you guys. So let me put down x factorial. And this right here is equal to the integral from 0 to infinity, t to the x power, and you multiply this by e to the negative t's power dt. And this integral is from the pi function or the gamma function. And yes, I have a lot of videos on those things already. And with this right here, you can do a lot more with factorials, such as we can talk about 1/2 factorial. You can talk about negative 1/2 factorial. You can talk about pi factorial. You can talk about e factorial. Of course, we can also talk about square root of 2 factorial. But you also have to be careful. Sometimes we cannot do certain factorials, such as negative 1 factorial. That actually doesn't have an answer. But once again, I'm going to leave all that to you guys. Today, this is the deal. So, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome square root of 2 factorial. This right here is nicely equal to the integral from 0 to infinity, t to the square root of 2 power times e to the negative t dt. And yes, this right here is an improper integral because we go from 0 to infinity, but this right here nicely converges. So we have a finite value for that. But no, I don't think I can actually do integration by parts, whatever integration technique to actually integrate this and then have an answer in the closed form. I don't know how to do that. If you guys know how to do it, leave a comment down below and let me know. But I do have a very nice question for you guys, so continue watching. Don't just go to the Wolfram Alpha right away, all right? So let me just pause it right here. First of all, we will be doing an approximation for this. And this is an improper integral. So to approximate an improper integral, of course, we will have to use a proper integral to do so. And the trouble of this right here is because of the infinity. So this is going to be my first try, and let me just put this down right here for you guys. To approximate this, let's talk about the integral from 0 to just 10, right? Let me just pick this for you guys. And of course, the inside stays the same. We have all this. And now, this is a much better integral to deal with. We can do some approximation. And perhaps the best approximation technique we have talked about so far is the Simpson's rule, so we'll do that right here. So suppose we are going to use Simpson's rule by Simpson's. And when you use Simpson's rule, you have to pick an n value. And let's just say n is equal to 20. And I'm not going to write down the answer right here for you guys. And you might be wondering, this is improper integral going from 0 to infinity. And I just use from 0 to 10. Is that even enough, even though I say n is equal to 20? Well, I have another proposal for you guys. This is going to be my second try. Suppose I go from 0 to 20. And of course, the inside stays the same. So this time, you see, I have a longer interval. So of course, this perhaps is better compared to that, right? Because this is going from 0 to 20. This is only going from 0 to 10. We need to go from 0 to infinity, right? But anyway, the trade-off that I will make right here is that I will still use the Simpson's rule, just to be fair. But this time, I will just pick n to be 10, OK? So my question for you guys is that, which one right here do you think it's actually a better approximation to this? Leave a comment down below and let me know. Is it the first one or the second one? Go ahead, comment down below. I trust you guys. Okay, cool. So you guys can find more links in the description because I have videos on the Simpson's rule already. And I will just tell you guys what the answers are. All right. If you go from 0 to 10 with n equals 20, the answer that you get is approximately 1.2560 and so on, of course. And if you go from 0 to 20, which is the longer interval, And if you just use at least sq equal to 10, the answer is approximately 1.2305, and so on. Well, of course, you wouldn't know which one's better unless we have the actual answer right here, right? And of course, we will have to use Wolfram alpha for this. So I will just put this down by Wolfram alpha. The answer that you get on this is approximately 1.2538. So, as you can see, the better of choice is actually this one right here. This one wins. Even though you have a smaller interval, but if you have a bigger n value, maybe it's better than having a longer interval with less n value, right? And perhaps the moral behind this story is that sometimes you may just want to focus on certain things and then just do really well on them instead of trying to do lots of things and then just do like half jobs on all that. Here's a quick reason why from 0 to 10 is actually just enough. Well, when you have e to the negative t, this right here, multiply with this. In fact, this actually converges pretty quickly, so from 0 to 10 is pretty good. And once again, if you focus on this interval with a bigger n value, yeah, you get a better answer. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and if you'd like to have more questions to work with, then I would highly recommend you to check out brilliant.org, especially now they have this new daily problems. And let me show you guys this one right here. It's math and logic, and this one is in probability. Here's the question. We are trying to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 on the dice, and which one is more likely? Shall we just use one die and roll it 6 times, or shall we get 6 dice and roll them at the same time? Of course, you guys can choose the answer here, and I will leave this to you guys. And if you guys like this question, you guys can also go to left because you guys can click on the quiz and you can see more similar questions. And if you guys would like to sign up for their courses, which are decided in an interesting and creative way, you guys can use the link brilliant.org/blackberrypen, because this way you guys can get 20% off discount and you can get access to all of these courses, which are really, really cool. Keep in mind, practice is the key to get better, and practice right is also a crucial part. Use brilliant.org so you will enjoy the learning process. And once again, thank you guys so much for watching the video, and as always, that's it. I will do the I factorial for you guys soon.